Thank you for inviting me. This organization, Chazak, I only heard good things about it. I want to thank all the people that take care about it. And Hashem, Bezrat Hashem, will give you the strength to continue. And Bezrat Hashem, make more and more classes, more and more shiurim, more and more chizuk. Amen keni ratzon. I have a shul in Brooklyn, and I have a kollel. We have like 35 guys that we train them, and we learn together. They're going to be rabbis, Bezrat Hashem. And that's what we're working on throughout the year. And also we're dealing with a lot of questions of halacha, and lo aleinu gitin, and kiddushin, and all whatever the Jewish person has in his life. I am mostly dealing during the day with halacha, and therefore I like to open this lecture with a question. The question is like this. Some family lady invite her friend for Shabbat meal. And they come and enjoy, they eat together, have a good time. And Motzei Shabbat, this lady heard that the other lady wasn't so happy with the food, and she started to talk. So she called her. She says, I want you to pay me for the food that you ate. So the question is, if she allows, she need to pay. Or maybe not. What do you think?
No. She probably won't anyhow.
Did she tell her in advance?
No, she doesn't tell her nothing. Another question. Another question. I invite a guy, I want to paint my house. I invite a guy. He told me, listen, this cost you $1,000. What's the color? I told him what I need. And he's supposed to do the job tomorrow morning. In the night I called him, I told him, listen, I don't want you to come. I want to think about it. I'm not sure, this and that. In the next morning he came. I wasn't in the house, he went to the house and he painted the house. Do I have to pay him?
No.
No.
Did he get the message first?
He got the message.
Did a good job.
He did a good job. So the answer is, on these two questions, that we have principle in the Torah, that whatever you enjoy, you have to pay. Everything that you enjoy in this life, you have to pay for it. It's not free meals. Everything that somebody gives you something, you have to pay for it. You enjoy, you like this color, okay, you didn't call him, but you like it. You don't have to pay him the full price, but you have to pay something. There is a question halacha. You eat by this lady, she has to pay for it. Why do you think it's for free? Who give free? Everything gets charged today. According to the Torah, there is rule, it's called nehene. Whatever you enjoy, you have to pay. So if this is true, we're a big, big problem. Because when we're going up to Shamayim after 120, and we says to Hashem, where is my Gan Eden? Listen, I came to Chazak classes, I came this, where's all my Gan Eden? Well, you promised me, the rabbi speaks. You know what Hashem will say? Listen, you ate oshpelo, you ate sushi today, no? Yeah, this, who is going to pay for it? You enjoy from this world. You have to pay all your mitzvot, go for paying whatever you ate, whatever you enjoy. You went to vacation, you went to Cancun. I'm sorry, zero balance. I don't know what this rabbi of Chazak told you.
We'll send the bill.
But you have zero balance because you all what are you everything you ate. Finish.
You want us to pull out our wallets now?
What, how we could enjoy from this world and not to get built from it? Not Hashem will not get, tell us, listen, I'm sorry, you have to pay. It's a big secret, huh? You know how much money this answer cost? There is a question the opposite way. The Rambam asks this question. The Torah promises us, V'aya im shamo tishmeu el kol mitzvot Hashem. Hashem will give us food and rain, and you give a good life. So the Rambam asks the opposite question. He asks, and we know that Hashem, if you want to pay you for mitzvah, I can't pay you in this world. Let's say you did a chesed to somebody. What Hashem will give you? Building in Manhattan? What are you going to do with this? After 120 years, finish, it's gone. How much schnitzel you can eat a day? Finish. What are you going to do with such big money? We can't pay you something spiritual that you did with something physical. It's not nothing. What you could... So how Hashem promised everything that if you do mitzvot, you're going to get a good life? Says the Rambam, you know, if you work for a company, if you work for a company, they give you a car, they give you to go sometimes to vacations, they give you gas, they give you salary, whatever you need. You need to go to a hotel, we give you a hotel. You go to business deal, we give you whatever you need. Go to restaurant, we give you the restaurant. Why come they give you so much stuff? Let's say you're going to Manhattan to eat and drink coffee and cake in the fanciest restaurant. How much it will cost? $60? Huh? $100? If the guy that works in the restaurants wants to drink this coffee, how much he will pay? He will pay zero. The Rambam says, Hashem says to us, if you work for me, you don't get charged. Because you work in my company. Whatever you do to me, you came to this world to do what? To work for me, to do for me. So I'm not going to get charged you nothing. Because whatever you eat, why you eat for? In order that you could serve Hashem. Like the Shulchan Aruch says, in Shulchan Aruch, kol ma'asav yu l'shem shamayim, whatever you do is for the sake of Hashem. You go to sleep. Why you go to sleep for? To go to work. What do you need to go work for? What's the end? The end is what? To do l'shem shamayim. So if you do everything l'shem shamayim, Hashem says everything goes on me. On my account. Because why? Because you don't have to pay. You don't need to pay. Because everything is in my account. If it's my account, you, all your mitzvot go for you. The money, whatever you get, you want to go to vacation, you want to go, everything included in the company. If you work for my company, you work for my company. But there is a, you have to ask ourselves, do we work in the company of Hashem, or do we work in the company for us? Who we work for? Why you wake up in the morning? Why you go to work? Who we work for? We work for ourselves or we work for Hashem? And if we work for ourselves, it's a big danger because we're going to get billed on every single thing that you did in life. You know, sometimes I get the credit card and I say, this one, I didn't do it. This one, I didn't do it. This one. And then I call them and say, no, this one, oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. This one, oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. You come to Shamayim, hello, you buy, you bought Tropicana in 7-Eleven, 1995, 7 a.m., you get charged for it. The sukkah that you build is for it. What? Yeah. What do you think? There is two ways to do the mitzvot. There is a way to do, I'm living my life. And there is mitzvot, so I'll do the mitzvot by the way. And there is a way to live that I'm not living for myself. I came to this world to be mekadesh Hashem Shamayim. Every mitzvah that I do, every mitzvah that I doing, I mekadesh Hashem Hashem, I'm working for Hashem, I don't need nothing for me. And Hashem knew inside our heart, if we will it like this, or we play games. You know, I met in my life people that really like this. They were whenever they eat something, they say, I eat now in order to have strength to work for Hashem, to do mitzvot. I'm going to sleep now in order that I have the strength to serve Hashem. I go even to vacation to change in order that I can have strength that I could come back, I could go and learn better. I could be with my wife, I could build my family. Why? In order to serve Hashem in the best way. There is two ways you could eat hamburger. You could eat hamburger because I need strength, or you eat it because you like it. You like the ketchup on top of it. Two ways. Everything is in here. Hashem look inside, and you know what happened in your brain, and he decide if you did it for you or for yourself. For yourself or for Hashem. Everything is depend, same action, exactly the same action, it depends if you did it to yourself or you did it for HaKadosh Baruch Hu. I know a guy, you know, in Israel, there is a city in the south, it's called Ofakim. It's 1 hour and 30 minutes from Bnei Brak. The guy was standing by the exit for the Ofakim in the highway, and he waited for a ride. Another guy told him, what you need to stop by him? He said, what you need to? I need to go to Bnei Brak. He says, now it's 11 p.m. Why you go to Bnei Brak 11 p.m.? He says, I missed Arvit in Minyan. And the only Minyan is in Bnei Brak, 1 hour and 30 minutes drive. And I know, I don't want to miss Arvit in Minyan. So I want to take a ride and I will praise her. This guy says, okay, come, I'm going to Bnei Brak. And he took him. And in the way he told him, listen, what are you going to do after? When you come there at 12:30, you're going to pray in Itzkovich, some shul over there that opened till like 3 a.m. And then what are you going to do? He says, listen, there is a yeshiva, a big yeshiva, Ponovich. It's open all night. I'm going to learn there. And in the morning, I'll take the first bus back at 5 a.m. Or either maybe after I finish Arvit, there is somebody going to give me a ride back. I'm going to find somebody. The guy was very impressed for him. He says, for Minyan, that's what you do? He says, I don't want to miss. Amen. I don't want to miss Baruch Hu et Hashem Avorach. So he told him, listen, if you don't find nothing to do after you finish, if you're tired, come to my house. He gave him his phone number. Call me, come sleep by my house. He says, okay. They went to Bnei Brak, 12:30, he pray, Arvit in Itzkovich finish, 12:45, 10:01. And this guy waits, he wants to know what's going on with this guy. After 15 minutes, half an hour, he see this guy didn't call him, so he called him back. He said, where are you? I'm waiting for you. I wanted to come to my house. He said, what are you talking about? I'm on the way back to Ofakim. And when I finish Arvit, I hear two guys speaking, they have to go rush because they need to go to Ofakim. So I told him, can I go with you? We're on the way back already. If the person wants to go in the way of Hashem, Hashem will give him all the opportunity. But there is of the Hashem that doesn't want to miss nothing in this world, not every cake in the store that you could miss, but every opportunity to serve Hashem. You know, was very big rabbi that passed away not long ago, Rav Malka. So maybe you heard about him. He used to come to Brooklyn a lot. And one of the rabbis told me that he used to pray only Birkot HaShachar about 2 hours. So sometime he came back from Chatuna, wedding, 12 o'clock, he says to the rabbi, take me to Landau's to pray. He said, what do you mean? We pray in the hall. He says, no, but I missed Kaddish Titkabal. I want to hear Kaddish Titkabal. We came to this world to do different job that we would think. And why we don't do this job? Because when we come to this world, too much around it, they take us away from our job. I'm sorry for the camera, I don't know, it's good. It's good?
Distractions.
You know, by the Goyim, they have a food, it's called sartan. How do you call it in English?
Crab.
Huh?
Crab.
Shem Yerachem.
Crab.
Crab. This crab, how you make it ready to eat? You boil it in hot water. That's how you prepare it. But the Goyim knows that if you're going to have hot boiled water and you're going to throw this crab inside, it's going to jump right from the heat, it's going to jump right away outside. So what they're doing, they put a cold water and they put this sartan, this crab inside, and they put it on the stove, and they put it a little bit hot, and then a little bit hot, and then a little bit hot, till they get cooked and you don't even realize. The Chazon Ish, 1950, he screamed, don't have radio. What you want? What radio could do bad? Don't listen to news. And the news of 1950, no murder and no bad things. He says, no, Charlie Chaplin, black, white TV. Says the Chazon Ish, Asur, Ya'areg, Ubal, Ya'avor. What do you want? What do you want? What's wrong with Charlie Chaplin? Then come TV with colors, Mickey Mouse, this, that. Then it come Kvalim with, you know, Lavian, how do you say in English?
Satellites.
Huh?
Satellites.
Then after 32 channels. Then after Interchet. Then after Sefer HaPanim. Sefer HaPanim ba'achrei zeh. They put that in Charlie Chaplin cold water and they raise the temperature slowly till we got cooked. And now the rabbi screams, Facebook, Sefer HaPanim, Internet, we're already burned inside, what do you want? And we don't understand the rabbi even, what do you want? Because the rabbi is not into the pot. He's outside, he touched, he says, come on, it's fire, yeah, get out. And he says, no, it's warm, nice here. And we're busy all day, looking for nonsense. There is some baby that put socks in his mouth, they put it on this, and everybody talks about it. What you crazy people? His wife make a cake, who took a picture of this cake, talk about this cake, nice, nothing. That's busy nonsense, spending their life. I see guys 40, 50 years old cutting a fruit in the train. Ninja food, how it's called? You're 40, 50, you have a grandson. What are you doing? Hashem will come to Shamayim. Hashem will tell you, what you did? I give you half hour in life. What you did in this half hour? I cut fruit. I play Subway. I ran after nobody. That's what you did all your life? People spend hours and hours. I know kids next to the computer Sunday from 9 a.m. to 9 p.m. And even go to bathroom is emergency. Spending all the life on shtuyot. You know, if somebody have half an hour to live, the doctor says, listen, you have half an hour to live. What is going to tell the doctor? Give me iPad, I need Subway Surf immediately. I want to play this game. That's what he says. So why half an hour in the middle of the life is the same thing? You know, the Gemara said, if I take now somebody's phone, iPhone, should they do it, and take it through the window, okay? And then somebody in the street going to see it in the air, he take a baseball bat and break it in the air. Who has to pay? The guy that threw it or the guy that break it downstairs?
Break it downstairs.
Somebody say somebody? Something? You said somebody? No one knows.
He said Baba Kama is already broken.
Shouldn't have been thrown. And once it falls, it's a test where anybody can take it and do whatever you want.
So who is gonna have to pay?
The guy threw it.
The guy that threw it, yeah. But he was complete in there. Nothing, no scratch even. So the Gemara said, like this guy says nicely, the Gemara said, every item in the world is worth, it's what people would pay for it. Mm-hmm. Right? How much this worth? How much money? How much people, what people going to pay for it?
Value.
Value, right? So this iPhone, when in the air is going to break on the street, how much people will pay for it? It's about to break in 2 seconds. How many people will pay for it? Huh? $0. No, I don't believe it. $0 is going to be in there worth $0. So the guy that break it, how much he break? $0. Correct? Now, if somebody take a person and he throw him from this window, and somebody going to shoot him in the air, who is the murderer?
The shooter.
The guy that threw him,
or the shooter? The Gemara said. The Gemara said the guys actually killed him because he took away 2 seconds from his life. Mipnei shekitzer mitato. You know, these 2 seconds in his life is totally different olam haba. Maybe he was in 2 seconds, will think about something Torah. Maybe he will think something to do tshuva. Is totally different olam haba for eternity because it's 2 seconds. You know what's 2 seconds in life? You could get different olam haba. So I tell your friend, wait a second. People go to movie, 2 hours. 2 hours I see it, my cry inside. 2 hours, and then they come out and say, stupid movie. And then they don't even know what happened, don't remember nothing. I don't talk about even bad thing in the movie. Forget about the bad thing. I'm talking about take our life and take it. We rip it to pieces. Hashem give us big neshama. You know, many, many years ago, he was a guy that he was very, very rich. And he ordered a very fancy table. And the guy that made this table charged him a lot of money. I know a guy that today bought a table, $100,000. I know the guy that made it told me this table cost $100,000. What is $100,000? I don't know. That's what it cost. He prepared for this man, this rich man, very fancy table. He paid for it $500,000, something that no one saw in his life. Very fancy. This guy, this rich guy, slowly started to lose his money. Start to lose his money, start people come to take all what he have. They start to sell his stuff in a place where they're selling, they want to take the money. Start to sell, they sell it for cheap. And then they sell it to somebody else, and then they sell somebody else, and somebody else. This table, after a few years, end up by some guy that is shoemaker. And he put... It was cheap, and he put all his stuff on it. There's the nails, there's the hammer, and all this stuff. And this guy, they made the table one time, he went in Vilna, in this city, and his shoes got ripped, and he says, I'm going to go to the shoemaker. Then he go into the store, and then he look at the table and says, I can't believe it. That's my table, I say for $500,000. He told the guy, you know, this table, how much? He said, what are you talking about? I put it, all the nails on the... It's nothing. Hashem give us neshama, chelek eloka mimal, proud of him inside our body. And what we do with this neshama? Interchet. Baby who sucks in his mouth. That's what the people take a picture and discuss about all day. Shtuyot, what happened in Mexico, what happened in Norvegia, what happened in this? All the world became such nonsense. Why? We have such an expensive thing in our body and we use it for shtuyot. Therefore, we have to know, everything what Hashem made is for us. If we work in the company of Hashem, Hashem says everything is belong to you, no charge. You know, the Or Sameach asked a beautiful question. He asked, what more important, the life of a Jewish person or the Shabbat? Life of the Jewish person, much more important. Lady that's going to give birth, you allowed to be Mechalel Shabbat on her?
Yes.
100%. Why? Because she's willing to give her, it's a Sakanat Nefashot, she might die. Woman, when she gave birth, it's dangerous, she might die. I told to husband one time, I told to husband, listen, you're willing to die for your wife? He can't complain, my wife, tell him, listen, if your wife wants you to die for her, you willing to do it? Ah, Rabbi, till here, I told you, your wife willing to die for you to have a baby. You allowed to be Mechalel Shabbat. Why? Because it's Sakanat Nefashot. The life of the Jewish person, it's much more important than all the Torah. So the Or Sameach asks, how come, if this is true, how come the Shabbat, if somebody mechalel Shabbat, what a punishment? We stone him. So how come, if the Shabbat more important, so how come, so what's going on? If the Jewish person is more important, so why are you killing him if mechalel Shabbat? What's more important? You told me the life of the Jewish person is more important. So why if the Mechalel Shabbat you killed him, he's more important.
He killed himself when he breaks Shabbat.
He didn't kill anyone. He just want to have Marlboro. Why? Ask the Or Sameach. Why we take away the life of a person if he Mechalel Shabbat? From the other side, we have to what? To save somebody if Sakanat Nefashot. Says the Or Sameach, I tell you why. Because only the guy that worked for Hashem, and he's a company of the Jewish nation, and he's all his life deduct to Avodat Hashem, Hashem says, everything I will give for you. Even the Shabbat. All the mitzvot is nothing but your life. It's more important than everything. Because you work in my company, you work for me, you do Kiddush Hashem, you come to this to fulfill mitzvot. Once you don't keep Shabbat, you out of then different rules. Then the Shabbat is more important than you. When you do keep Torah mitzvot, you're more important than Shabbat. When you don't, the Shabbat is more important for you. And all your life, whatever you do, think about, I'm doing it for the sake of Hashem. Everything that you do, when the minute you wake up in the morning, till you go to sleep, think about, I'm doing it for the sake of Hashem. Not for my, you know, there is in Israel, 100 years ago, I was in Europe, a lady, she has the most beautiful voice in the world. You know this? She was a Jewish girl. She's the most beautiful voice in the world. All the people, they heard it, almost faint. And then start people to come, and a lot of suggested for work, millions of dollars, famous, be in the news, people going to run after you to the wherever you go, kavod, money, whatever you need. And she wanted to do it. Her father told her, listen, Jewish girl cannot sing in public. But ma Abba, listen, do you see what's after me? Hashem give me a present. She said, Asur. She couldn't listen to him. You know, there is, in parentheses, there is a very famous singer that used to learn in Yeshiva of Brooklyn. You know?
His name is Diamond.
Huh?
Diamond.
Barbara. She thought she's going to get rich, she's going to send Yeshiva a check. The Rabbi Mandel says, I don't need your money. Don't give me your money. When you do Averot, I don't need the money. Every money that you do through Avera, you know who signed the check? Satan. A Satan signed. If you cheat somebody in the business, and you make money, a Satan sign on the check. And then you up Shammai, Satan, come. I give you money all your life. You belong to me. The Zohar said so. Everything that you do in cheating, you know, every penny that not belong to you, no bracha on it. No bracha. The Beit HaLevi was big rabbi 150 years ago, one time he sits by Shabbat table, a lot of guests, a lot of food, and some, you know, sometimes he's a fat guy, he sits like this, and then the table cover was tied to his button, and then he stand up, everything fall. The spoons, the plates, the cups, everything fall to the floor. Rabbi says, don't worry, nothing break. Pick up everything. How bad do you know? Nothing break really. He says, because I have no $1 that not belong to me. Everything that there is my money, I know is 100% kosher. Then you have beracha. You know, there is a guy, remind me to go back to the story of this. there is a guy in Israel, they went one rabbi, he went to the car service. The car service tried to cheat him. He told him, instead of 10 shekel, he told him 20 shekel. This guy told him, why you charge me so much? So that's why, oh, don't give me this, go away, don't come. You know the Israelis. And he gave him 20 shekel. He told him, listen, there is 10 shekel for the ride and 10 shekel for your dentist. And he left the car. And this guy says, what? Wow. And he starts running after him, says, no, take back the 10 shekel. I don't want problem, don't dentist, because this dentist has no rahamim, no mercy. As he run after him, and this guy says, the rabbi says, I don't want to back that, I don't want it. It's for your dentist, I told you, I don't take it back. He says, please, rabbi, take it back, please, I don't want. He says, listen, I don't take it back, I told you it's for your dentist, have a good day, go away. And then he ran after him to the yeshiva, and then the rabbi said, only one condition, I will take it back. If you promise me and you sign to me, that you're never going to cheat anyone in your life. So I will take this $10 back. And he promised him. And that's what happened with everything that not belong to us. It's very tempting when you see something, it's very easy. Because let's say we close the light in Macy's for 5 minutes. What's going to be there? Huh? You think something, everything will stay the same? You know what does it mean? It means that most of the people on the earth, the stealer, they just don't steal because they're scared from the police, but inside the stealer. Because if you steal, when nobody sees you, you really stealer. Just you don't do it because you're scared. Doesn't mean that you're not bad person. You are a bad person. But you don't do it because you're scared from the police. So most of the people, I don't know, the goyim, they probably will steal, no? There is maybe one or two good guys. But a Jewish person, I will not touch something that will not belong to me. The Beit HaLevi was 20 shekel on his, whatever, on his desk for many, many years, and he didn't touch it. Because once you touch it, Oh, it's chayav, chaza, shavat aveda, pilpulim. I don't want to touch. They don't touch nothing. You know, if you go in Shabbat, let's say you go in Shabbat. What's the name of the street here? 108. 108. You go in Shabbat, you see stuff like this of $100 bills. $10,000. You pick it up or no? Step on it, sit on it, give it up. Da, 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 da. I'm telling you, I don't know what you're going to do. It's a very big test. Very big test. But I promise you one thing. That if you're going to pick it up and you're going to say, it's monopoly money, it's fake, you're going to be very upset. Because you also did the Avera, and you also did the fake money. But every Jewish person knows that even if the real, it's a fake, if it's involved with Avera. That's what you have to put in your mind. So this lady, we'll go back to the story of this lady. She told her father, I can't do it, I have a nice voice. And she go back and she start. But then big rabbi came to the city and her parents told her, listen, go meet with this rabbi. The rabbi told her, listen, I know you have very big test. I know it's hard for you. I know you could be famous with a lot of money. But I promise you one thing. If you willing to give it, I give you much bigger present. I will bless you that you're going to have a son that will be famous in Torah. And his divrei Torah will lead the whole world. And she went home and she think about 3 days. And then decide to do it, not to go to the to be a singer. And she stayed in her house, and she got married. And her son today is one of the biggest rabbis in Israel. It's called Shevet Alevi, Rab Shmuel Vosner. Somebody knows. He's a chief rabbi of Nebrak. He has 20 books, and all the Sofrim, all everybody is. He's a big, big guy in Israel. One of the biggest. He's a very close friend with Chacham Ovadia. And one of the rabbis in Israel went to Rab Shmuel Vosner, tell him, listen, do you know this story is true or not? He says, I don't know, I never heard about this story, but I know one thing. My mother always told me, Shmuel, learn good and pray good because I gave up a lot of things to you. Because when you give up something, you feel much better. You know, there is a girl, the people, diet. They go on diet, right? They go on diet. What more delicious, the taste of the cake or the taste that you didn't eat the cake and you be able to
conquer
yourself. So the person much more happy when he know that he came to this world and he worked everything for Hashem and he knows that whatever Hashem gave him, it's only in the way that you could be able to work and to do the mitzvot from Hashem. You know, if someone ask a rabbi what we could do in order to pass the test. You see a test, what you could do to pass the test. So I'd give you two answers based on Chazal. One answer is, it's very easy. You just have to let's say you want to speak Lashon Hara? Huh? Let's see, you want to look something you're not supposed to? Think about what I told you now. Once, when my kid was a baby, I used to wake up in the night for him. When my wife forced me, I can't do it, I have to wake up. So I wake up, and there is a minhag to put under the baby the Sefer Noam Elimelech. You heard about this Sefer? It's a shmirah for keep the baby safe. So I didn't know what to do. I start to learn about from it what I'm going to do. So I open, and then I saw something unbelievable that he said. He said, he asked a question: does Hashem scared for something? Hashem scared from something, and he says yes. Hashem scared when a person about to do Avera. Hashem wants you to pass the test, but he can't get involved because it's against the rules. Hashem could give you food, give you health, give you money, but he can't get involved with you, Yirat Shamayim, with you, Torah. It's everything belongs to you. Hakol bidei Shamayim, chutz, Mirat Shamayim. That's Hashem said, I can't do nothing, but I want you, please. Like he told Avraham Avinu, stay, work this nisayon. You know, if you go to a wedding and then you see a nice cake, and you want to take it, but you're in diet, and then you say, I will take it, I will not take it. I will take it, not take it. Then you see 100 lady and told you, CP, don't take it. CP, don't take it. CP, please don't take it. CP, screaming. You will take it?
What do you think?
There is 100,000 people will tell you, CP, don't take the cake. CP, you're going to take the cake? You know what happened in Shamayim when a person had a test? You want to say Lashon Hara so juicy. There's a lot of details. With a lot of, you know, divorce, and she buried, and she this, my sister-in-law, my mother-in-law, my this, you know, what she did, what she told me, you know, juicy, very juicy. In Shamayim there is hundreds of angels and says, please don't do it, please don't do it. Moshe, don't do it. Screaming, 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 and Hashem scared, and Hashem is shaking, and Hashem says, please don't do it. And then if you don't do it, and you hang up the phone, Hashem says, ah, oof, this was hard. And the old angel says, oh, thanks to her, this was almost a Satan win us, and change the whole picture of the Jewish nation in one Lashon Hara. He was very scared from this one. And if you did it, whoa, what's going on in Shammai? Just think about it, I promise you're not going to do any Averot. Don't forget what I told you tonight. And connected to it, till when we have a rabbi? Yeah? Okay. We're going to finish 1 a.m. Okay. I'm talking.
Make it 3 in the
We said every morning, Modeh o moda ani lefanecha, melech chai vekayam, shechezarta bi nishmati bechemla rabba emunatecha. Why we say emunatecha? We're supposed to say emunatecha. Who believe in who? We believe in Hashem, or Hashem believe in us? We say Modeh Ani every morning, thanks to Hashem, that you believe me. Rabbi Emunatecha, you have great belief on me. What's going on? I said it 50 years, I never realized. Huh? You know what we say over here? We say something unbelievable. Every night, the Neshama leave our body and go up to Shamayim. And it's very scared way, scary way. Why? Because when the Shama not in the goof, it's very easy to take it and not to give you back. That's why we say Kriyat Shema every night, to protect the Neshama when she go up. If you don't say Kriyat Shema, you go to Gaza without weapons. Telling you, be careful. The Neshama goes, say, Yoshev Beseter Elyon, we need angels, Shishim, שישים מסביב לשלמה, נכון? הנה מתתו של שלמה, 60 גיבורים מסביב למגיבורי ישראל, 60, we need 60 soldiers. And we put all the neshama with a lot of Torah around, and there is tzaddikim that think in Torah till they fall asleep. The neshama go up on shamayim, and then all the mekatregim, how do you say mekatregim? The people that, prosecutors. The prosecutor says to Hashem, wow, this woman, don't give her back to Neshama. You see, you give her Neshama Teora without any Avera when she born, and then what happened? She speaks yesterday Lashon Hara. She didn't go in Tzniut. She's doing a lot of bad things. Why? She doesn't do Hasadim all day, Menikur, Pedikur. And then, she. She don't do nothing. Or this man, vice versa. Why, this man, what he did? All the day, finish the news on the internet, and he go from this to place, ask from CNN on BBC, why he said over there this and that, and then he go see Hashem Yerachem, and then spending his life only in Torah, don't know Chassadim, embarrass his wife, curse. Why giving back this neshama, this guy? Why for? Leave it there, much safer. And Hashem said, don't. Give him back. I believe in him. Today he's going to change. And the neshama go back to us and we said in the morning, Hashem, how much you believe in us? We don't believe ourselves so much. And then next day come, and again, Hashem says, give it back. Today is going to be the day. 120 years, Hashem says, give it back. Today is going to change. And you go in the street, and the next day, think about it, that Hashem wants to do in the night, to tell the angels, you see, it was worth it. Because if the person come to this world and be able not to do averot, he's much greater than the angels. Because the angels don't have yetzerah. So why you lose it for nothing? Why we lose it? Therefore, we Baruch Hashem, we be able, Hashem in Shavuot, we pass Shavuot, give us not only the Torah. You know the Midrash. The Midrash says when Hashem gave the Torah, all the angels says, don't give the Torah. Leave the Torah by Shamayim. You know this Gemara? Mm-hmm. Ask a simple question. Why Hashem didn't do both? Give the Malachim and give to us. What's wrong? You can't go to Eichler, buy another copy. What's wrong? Why he says, oh them or you? Fight. Moshe Rabbeinu, fight. Alita lamarom, shavita shevi, you capture the Torah. Why fighting for? Give two. One to the angel, one to us. No, when Hashem gave us the Torah, he gave us the key of the world. The tzaddik is in charge of the world. He could say, split this river and the river will split. He could say, I want to drink now water, the ground will open and you're going to have a water. Because the Torah have the key of the world. Hashem istakel b'Torah u'barat ha'olam. And therefore, every time that a person go up and up, he is in charge of this world. And the Jewish nation in charge of all the world. You know, Pasuk in Shir HaShirim, Lesusati berichvei paro, dimitich ra'ayati. You know this Pasuk? What the translation? You, my wife, you like, you nice, and beauty like the horse of Paro. What does it mean? Somebody going to tell his wife, I love you like the horse of Paro. Huh? Hashem told to us, we are the Kala of HaKadosh Baruch Hu, and Hashem told to us, you like the sus of Paro. Usually, who decide where to go? The guy on the horse or the horse? The guy on the horse, he's in charge, whatever the horse will go. But in Egypt, in Mitzrayim, Berichve Paro, even if the guy wants to go a different way, Hashem made the horse go into the water. So Hashem says to the Jewish people, listen to me. You are like the horse of Paro. Whenever you go in the way of Hashem and Torah mitzvot, you in charge of the world. I'm going to be after you. You're going to be the sus of Paro. That you're going to decide where to go and we'll go for you. Because whatever Hashem brings on the world is for the Jewish people. To learn Musar, everything is for the Jewish people. And therefore, we got so much, and you can't give it to both, either the Malachim or us. Who's going to be in charge? And that's why the Malachim was very upset. Why you give it to the key of the world? You know, if the Halacha is here, Mutar, and you say Bat Kol Mishamayim, is the voice from Hashem, Asur, what the Halacha will be? Mutar. Why? Lo bashamaymi. The Torah is not where in the world, in the up in Shamayim, in the heaven. So that's why we got so much And we have to think, to walk. We walk in the company of Hashem. You know, everything in our head, whatever you do, whatever you think, think about, I will do in the sake of Hashem. All the mitzvot will be yours. Everything will be yours. You know, Rav Dessler said, the world is divided to two kind of people. People that take and people that give. What we'll do most of the day? You go to work. What are you doing in the work? You give or you take?
I'm giving your time.
You take as well.
You take. I want to take a lot, not too much money, not to give anything. I want only take. And a small mass. People want to make a deal. Come on, I want to make a deal. Right? Give me to the deal to work a short time and make a lot of money. There is a young guy, 17, 18, they think they're going to come, going to conquer the whole world. We're going to make a few deals, we're going to make... That's what people say. All day they want to take. In the marriage, people want to take or want to give? You know, the guy go first time with shiduch, I love you. He give her a flower. And she, oh! What's the word love mean? Some guy went to the restaurant, he told to the waiters, give me a fish. I love fish. I died for fish. I love fish. Burn good the fish. I like it. Burn him good. That's why few people told to the wife or to the kala, I love you so much, you don't love her. You want to burn her, you love yourself. Because you came to marriage for what? To take. Whatever, she's not pretty anymore. She's not giving you the right breakfast. So finish. That's it. But Hashem says we came to this world to give. Only to give. You know, in America there is equal rights. You know what's equal rights? Zchuyot. Bill of rights. What's a bill of rights? What my zchuyot? What my rights? In the Torah, the Torah is no bill of rights. All the Torah, you don't have any rights. You just have to give all day. Give and give and give and give. And everybody give to everybody. And therefore, everybody is happy. Because everybody has rights. Because everybody give to everybody. Also in the marriage, everybody will say, give me. Finish. The marriage will die. But if everybody wants to give to the other, so then maybe there is any hope for it. So you wake up in the morning, you say to yourself, what am I going to do today? I'm going today to give or to take?
To give.
Let's say some guy will call you, mothers, and will tell you, listen, tomorrow, leave your son by the 108th street and corner of 66, I will pick him up to school, don't worry, I will do it for you. And then he called to your neighbor, says, you know, you also could leave your son in 67th street, I'm going to pick him up. And then he called to another friend, said, leave him in 68, I will pick him up. What are you going to say about this guy? Huh? Wow, this guy is unbelievable. Every day you're going to do it for me? Psh. That is your bus driver. Rabbi, you get money. No, so what if he gets money? He did for you a favor. You can't take your son with money. You can't take your son on the money to the school. You need somebody to do it, right? But we don't think like this. Every person that do go to work has to think, I'm doing a favor to people. I'm helping people. You shoemaker, you're helping people. You go, you car service driving, you're helping people. You teacher, you're helping people. You're making money on the side, nothing to do. You're not used to the Torah to make money. But what you think about you, inside your brain, whatever you go to work, that's what's important. If people think all day, I want to take, I want to do, I want to find. So, they all day they're busy with taking, taking, taking. Then they want to take from everybody. But there is people go to work, I want today to do any chassadim to everybody. I'm going to make money also. But I help people, I'm selling shoes. You know, Chafetz Chaim one time came to the store, pharmacy. He needed a medicine. And he came to the pharmacy, and he paid the guy, he take the medicine, and tell the guy, I don't believe you. You're such a great guy. What I will do without you? You gave me medicine, I will take it. I'm going to feel better, I'm going to feel good. This guy says, oh, you're crazy. Whoa. I buy this medicine, 50, I say 100, that's it. Don't look in life like this. Don't look in life like this. It's a bad attitude. Whatever you do a favor in your life. Whenever you have, once I went to the car service, and I told them the same thing. Some Israeli guy took me, and I told him, listen, you're unbelievable. What I will do without you? He says, what do you want? I need $10. What do you want for my life? What do you want? I don't know, but you really help me also. Take the $10, but you really help me. Then you all life to chassadim. All your life you're busy with mitzvot. All your life you go, I want to work, I need money, not for myself, I want to give donation, I want to help chazak, I want to go to put my kids in a good education. I want to give my wife a good present. I want to make her happy. I want to buy a diamond for $5,000. She also go to work and whatever she does in the house, I want to, my husband will feel happy. Everything is building on giving, giving. Then you start to be strong in the midah of giving. Then you become a better person. Then Hashem says, this person I want. You know, there is people till they old, they don't change. You saw, you know, these old people always upset. Whoa, what do you take me? Why? Because all their life they didn't do nothing, only complain all day, and also sad and everything. Want to take from everybody, and then they come old and stay the same thing. I see people in the hospitals, 90 years old, just looking at the TV all day. Till they're going to be dead, they look at the TV. We're not going to leave the TV even 1 second. Because that's what they did all their life. If you're not going to change today, you're going to say the same thing. You know, there is a very rich guy. He was in some city, I forgot the name, in the middle of America. Very, very rich guy. He couldn't give donation in his life. Because what? He was very, 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 very stingy. Couldn't. And he was in the hospital on a deathbed, mamash, going to die. The doctor told him, a few hours. So he called Rabbi Schwab. And he says, Rabbi, I want to do vidui with me. And by the way, I left your envelope in the drawer. And the rabbi did vidui and he passed away. He opened the envelope, he said $500. The guy had $50 million. I can't. What do you think? You're going to change in the end? No way. Because whatever you go into, you midot, it's much harder and harder. Therefore, I tell the people, you have a phone, you know, today everything is I. Because I, iPhone, iPad, then they came with a game, it's called Wii. So I was happy. Then I see the double I. I said, what's going on?
Ay,
ay, ay. Ay, 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 ay. So everything is me, you know, used to be everything is lach, now everything is I, and people have these things in the phone. You have to raise everything is not kosher. You have to raise all your games. You have to raise everything. Be didak to Hashem. You have this yetzerah in your pocket, erase everything. Erase it. Then you're going to feel free. Put filter that you need, put whatever you need to be safe. You can't go in mekom sakana, the Gemara said. Let's say the guy wants to go to Cancun. He went to Cancun to the beach. He didn't go to the beach. He came with a 5 gemarot. He went up to his room, closed all the shades, sit there in Torah for a week, didn't leave his room. Take the airplane back to Brooklyn. What do you think about this guy? The Gemara says he's Rasha. Why you went there? You just opened the window and see the Gehenom. Why you went there? You put yourself in Nisayon. Even if you pass the Nisayon, you Rasha. Why you put yourself in Nisayon? So therefore, we don't want our Nisayonot. Al tevienu lide Nisayon velo lide Bizayon. Don't give us to Nisayonot because it's very dangerous. We couldn't handle it. So therefore, whatever you had in your life, try to think all day that I'm doing for the sake of Hashem. Because today there is a lot of problems in marriage, because everybody think about himself in the eye. Everybody don't think for the company to work for Hashem. There is a lot, you know how many divorces there is because Sefer HaPanim? You know, they put another section in the Rabbanut in Tel Aviv just for too much gittin, too much work. I know myself, few gittin that man, woman, they're looking for things they're not supposed to look. We learn the Torah. Matovu Alecha Yaakov, we sing under the chuppah. Matovu Alecha Yaakov, Mishkenotecha Yisrael. What's so good in Matovu Alecha Yaakov? What's so good in Oale Yaakov, in the tent of Yaakov? What's so good in it? The Gemara says the good in it, that it wasn't open one to another. It was like this. The tent would not open one to another. No one would allow to do and to look in the other people's house. And today, what happened? All the houses opened. You want to go to my house? Come on. Go on the computer, see everything. And you go, and then everybody involved with everybody, and therefore there is problems. You know, there was a lady told me, she went on Sefer HaPanim, she see a picture of her friend going to barbecue with her husband. Nice. Sunday, barbecue, they're doing. And she start to fight with her husband. Why you not like my, like the other husband? Why you don't take me, you see how she take? So I told this woman, how do you know what happened over there? Maybe they fight all day. Maybe they throw in each one meat on the head. They just took few good pictures and they put it, and that's it. But once you open your life to the other people, who knows what's gonna happen? You're not allowed to open your tent. And today we open everybody's tent, open to the other people. And they do, everybody look, what you ate, what you did, what you dressed, what is this, what your husband bought you. And a lot of problems with the cause. Therefore, we have to keep our family like we used to have. Everybody in his own tent. You can invite guests, but don't invite them to see something you're not supposed to. Everybody together, בעזרת השם, we succeed, להצליח, לעלות מעלה מעלה בתורה וירת שמיים. If you have any question, and you want to ask me, you're willing to ask me if I said something not clear, or you want to have a question, so if you want, I could answer you. If not, so...